Hello there, welcome to IQ Pop. In this video I will discuss about should statement in C. So here is the flowchart of should statement. So where do you use should statement and why do we need it? So what happens, we have if statement for decision making, but if allow us to choose among two different decision, right, based on the condition is whether it is true or false. True, you are going to have one path. If it is false, you can have another path. But if there is multiple choice and based on the condition you are going to choose one, then if is not going to help you efficiently. So it is kind of say when you call a customer care number, you will find they speak like this. Per choosing English, press 1. Hindi ke liye 2 dabaiye. Banglar junno 3 press korun. So that is the situation when we need switch. If we will not cater the situation enough efficiently. So here you can see here start, some expression is there, say what you are pressing 1, 2, or 3. Now if you press 1, it is going to follow the case 1 here and case 2, case 3, up to this there may be case n, and for each choice there is a block of code which is going to be executed. If none of the case are going to be chosen by the user, and say some case is chosen by the user which is not there as a case in switch, then it is going to enter in the default case, and there is a default block. So usually in default block what happens, they give some error message that you have chosen a wrong choice, right? So if you choose a wrong choice, then definitely there will be no case corresponding to that choice. So in that case default block is going to be executed. Okay, so every time you are entering into the switch case, this switch block, we call it switch block, starting from here to here, you can see either a single block is going to be executed. So there is no chance that you are going to execute more than one block until you are going to make some mistake or error like break. So what does this break does? Say you have chosen, say this switch is S is 1, so you are entering into case 1. So in case 1 there is code block 1, this is going to be executed. After execution at the last line, when it is high break, what happens is breaks the switch block and sends the control at the end of the switch. Okay, if you choose this expression match to case 2, it starts and executing the code which is in block 2, and again at the end of the block 2 there will be a break which will not allow you to enter in case 3 or block 3, okay, or in default. Okay, so once it is break means you are going to be out of the switch block. Now here is a problem. Design a calculator which will take two integer input and perform arithmetic operation based on user choice. So it is a kind of at the beginning one message will be displayed on the screen that for addition press 1, for subtraction press 2, for multiplication press 3, like this, and whatever the user will choose based on that it will give the result. Okay, what are the things you need? You need int a and b, two integer, and after that whatever arithmetic operation you are going to do on A and B, that result is going to be saved somewhere. Say R is result variable, the switch and the decision error what key user is going to press, I need to store somewhere, say S. Okay, now printf. User enter numbers. Addition. So we will display the result of addition. So here r equal to a plus b. Print f. Percent d r. So this is the addition result. Right, so in the same way for case 2 it is a subtraction, for case 3 it is multiplication, and for case 4 it will be division.
If it doesn't match any of these four, then it will enter in the default and will display printf. Wrong. Right. Okay. So our program is done. Right. This is the switch block, so let's run it. That is not a big issue, so I am just removing these things. Okay. Enter 1 for addition, enter 2 for subtraction and 3 for multiplication, 4 for division. So I'm entering 1. Okay. Enter 2 numbers, 8 and 9. See, result is coming 17. So it is working. Addition of 8 plus 9 is 17. Now what will happen if I enter some option or some, say I'm entering 8 is not there as a choice, so it is asking enter two number, see, wrong choice. So what choice you had made, that is wrong, right? So this is what switch gets. Now like, comment, share and subscribe, and stay with me to get more videos like this.